Hey guys, if you're in real estate and you're trying to get a website made, I need to point out one blaringly neglected step that chances are you are skipping. You see, I've launched hundreds of websites. I've actually even taken over quite a few from other web developers and designers. And from those websites that I have taken over, I've seen one blatant commonality, which really causes those websites to have horrible user experience and to say bluntly, looks so bad. And when I ask those probing questions about how they ended up in this position in the first place, I often get the same kind of answer, which is they hired a web designer or web developer and they designed something, programmed it, and launched it. Well, based on that information, I can tell you exactly why those websites failed. And it's because they're missing a step. Emmanuel here, and in today's video, I want to cover real estate wireframing and why it is so important. If you're planning to build out a real estate website, then wireframing is so vitally important. Yet one, you probably don't know what it is, and two, your web developer is probably too lazy to do it. Quick side note, if your web developer has not brought up wireframing as part of their process to you, then run for the hills. Chances are your finished product is gonna be something that you're not gonna be too happy about. You see, wireframing is so important. It really builds the foundational pieces of a website. Yet most web developers tend to overlook it. They go from discovery straight into design, programming, and launch. If you talk to the real professionals though, they never skip that step. They always go from discovery to wireframing, then to design, programming, and launch. And that's why a lot of the times they have a lot better looking and more successful websites. So what is wireframing, you may ask? The easy way to explain it is to sketch out the layout of a website so you can better identify all of the functions and features without actually having to design out all of the aesthetics right off the bat. It's the skeleton or the blueprint or the underlying mechanics, if you will. The process is super easy, it's really fast, and it's the quickest way to communicate layout, content, and functionality. Wireframing is so vitally important because it really helps you identify the underlying issues that can occur when designing out a website without actually going through the whole multi-day process of designing. And I should also add that wireframing helps the design process overall, thereby making the whole process so much more efficient. So what exactly does wireframing look like? Well, there are a ton of applications out there that you can use to wireframe, like Adobe XD or Sketch or Figma, but the best application of all is actually a pen and a piece of paper. You see, wireframing is not that complex. It's just a matter of sketching out your vision for the overall layout of a web page. You can easily do that by just drawing boxes to illustrate photos or video and drawing lines to illustrate text. Check out this quick example of me sketching out a homepage. All right, so take a look at this. Granted, it's not a piece of paper I'm sketching on my iPad, but I at least wanted to show you how the wireframing process looks like. Now, what you're looking at on the left side of the screen is a list of features that I want to create for my homepage. You're gonna wanna start with this step and list out all of the features that you're gonna wanna display on your potential webpage. So in this case, I want a search, I want properties, I want neighborhoods, about, and testimonial. So the next step is to start sketching out what this would potentially look like. We'll start with the overall webpage by drawing it out like this. There you go. All right, now let's start with the basics, like the navigation. So we probably have the logo here. You're probably gonna want some navigation links here and maybe a call to action right here, all right? And then next, I actually want, in my vision of this potential homepage, to be a pretty full-size homepage screen. And then within that screen, I wanna have a box here in the middle, it's called search. And then from there, I probably wanna have a section down here for properties. You know, the property description goes down here. And then I probably want to have a whole section right here for about, and I want to do something where like the video is kind of popped out a little bit. So I'm going to make this the play, and I'll probably have some information here about my agency. And then I maybe want to have some neighborhoods listed out here. And then I wanna have a whole section for testimonials. So I'll maybe like this and then like that. And then this would be my footer. By the way, quick pro tip for you guys. The human eye tends to look at websites in the F shape, and it typically looks like this.
The eye tends to read left to right like this, and then moves down, and then starts again left to right like this, and then moves down left to right, then down left to right, which essentially forms an F.
So, something to keep in mind when you're building out your wireframes. Now to wrap things up, you're going to be wanting to create wireframes for every single page that you've identified in your sitemap. And then from there, it will be super easy for you to design out the actual aesthetics of the user interface. You see how easy it is? Yet most designers and developers tend to skip this task. They typically go straight into design and development, and they end up finding out that they forgot or missed some underlying issue. And then what ends up happening is they have to rework the entire project, when the reality is they would have been able to mitigate these issues if they just did it right the first time. In any case, if you have any questions about wireframing, please feel free to reach out. It's one of the things that we do in our process, and we'll be happy to help. And if you have any questions about real estate web design, please feel free to reach out and schedule a strategy session call with us. We'll be happy to provide you with guidance, or maybe at least point you in the right direction. In any case, I hope you found this video valuable, and if you did, make sure you click that like button, the subscribe button, and the bell icon, because you know it helps out the video and the channel, and thank you so much in advance. All right, guys, that wraps it up. I will see you on the next video.